Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. In today's video, I'm going to share my top favorite beauty items with you and my most used items, obviously. I feel like during this quarantine, I've actually experimented much more with like different makeup looks. I've also been able to try out more products. I am normally very careful with this because I have a very sensitive skin, so I don't want to try out new stuff and then it gives me breakouts and stuff while I'm working and traveling, so I'm always a bit careful with that. But obviously while I was at home, I was able to try out different things and different makeup looks, and I feel I just also had more time to do this, so that was a lot of fun. So yeah, I'm going to share some I'm going to share some of my favorites with you guys. So here is my little beauty corner. I should definitely clean up my mirror here. So here I always have my everyday makeup, even though this is a lot of makeup. I'm not always wearing this, but I like to like switch it up. And then over here, just some more all like organized in here, like red lipstick. This happened during quarantine, doesn't always look like this. So yeah, here I have some of my favorite ones. I actually got this golden tray, I think at like Target or something, a long time ago. So here I have like my beauty items, or my my brushes. Here mostly like lip stuff, lipsticks, some like palettes, and I don't know where I got this thing. I think I got this marble thing at Amazon, and I have it same on this side. And then over here, cabinet, we have all skincare stuff. So Max and I share this, and it is a lot, guys. I'm not using this every day. So up here is obviously more like the everyday stuff. Then we love to organize everything by brand, so we can always find exactly what we need. Wow, with the mirrors there, it looks like this is an endless skincare cabinet. This is how much I love beauty. So here I have my favorite products from Orveda. Obviously, the Ise oils, which I'm going to talk about later. Then I have here hair stuff, like hairspray, whatever. I have Sonia Dekar stuff. This is my favorite perfume. These are lips. I have Omurovicka, Dr. Barbara Sturm, sunscreens. And here, this is more like makeup remover. I'm actually lately obsessed with these. These are like gentle eye makeup remover pads, but they work really well, and I just got this at CVS. Take off my makeup, and this is just like some everyday stuff. This is the Valhalla. You know what? I'm just going to grab some of my favorite items, and then I'm going to sit down and show you guys. I'm matchy-matchy with my setting today. As you guys know, green is my favorite color. I think you guys can probably guess what my number one favorite beauty item is of all times. The three Ise face oils. I co-founded Ise together with my really good friend Benny, and many of you guys know that we were gonna launch in March, but unfortunately due to coronavirus we couldn't do it, and we were like waiting, but we realized that back to normal is probably not gonna happen anytime soon. And that's why we launched Ise 2 weeks ago. We sold out immediately after the first week, so we were so excited that you guys can finally get your hands on this and use it. So there are three different ones. I just wanted to explain quickly each oil and like how to use it. So as you guys know, for me, natural clean products are so important because I'm very aware of what I put inside of my body, but I also want to make sure that the things I put on my body are pure and clean as well. So Ise, we have a calming face oil, we have a hydrating, and we have a brightening. You can say it's a light, medium, heavy. Hydrating is the most nourishing one. So I often use this in the evening when I go to bed, and really overnight, the oils can really penetrate my skin and really moisturize it. Then I have the calming, which is the medium one. And the calming one I use often when I have like a little breakout, or whenever I have like redness. An active ingredient there is actually CBD, which really restores and calms down the skin. So this is something very special actually also in a skincare product, because CBD hasn't been used a lot there. Then we have the brightening face oil, And the brightening one is really if I want to have this like glow. And this one is the lightest, so I often use this in the morning, or I mix this with my foundation in there. And they all are like clean, vegan, cruelty free, which was super, super important. They're also very sustainable. You can reuse them. So some of the active ingredients are jojoba. I hope I probably pronounced this completely wrong, which is an ingredient which like hydrates the skin. It has strawberry seed oil, cucumber seed oil, and avocado oil. I have the calming oil here, and the only thing you need is just a couple of drops like that. Mix it. I mean, I'm wearing a little makeup now, but you could even like put it on top to give it a little bit of extra shine. But obviously, normally I use this after my serum, and instead of a moisturizer, I use these oils right now. And this is literally the only thing I really, really need. This is something what Benny and I also really wanted, a product which really simplifies, but really works in your skincare routine. As you can hear, the name Easy Skincare Simplify. Easy is available right now. I will put a link in the description down below as well. And I will be so, so, so excited for you guys to try it. And I would love to hear you guys' feedback as well, because I have been using this for over, I think, 6 months. It's been ready. We've been working on this with a chemist, and who's absolutely amazing. And since then, my skin has been so smooth and glowy. Some people say it's me moving to LA. I say it is Easy. So one of my other favorite products, I'm actually not, I had the other day I had a call with Benny, and we were like, I don't understand what the relaxing factor is of face masks. I always find it so much like effort. It makes like a mess. And I know a lot of girls and a lot of you guys probably find it very relaxing, like a way of self-care. I find it making a mess, but I do think some face masks really, really work. And I have a very sensitive and dry skin. So whenever I want to put a mask on, which is a clay mask and really purifies and cleans out my skin, I often have the problem that it just completely cracks and it's super dry. The clay mask is way too intense for me. So I did found this Sonia Dakar, the Rose Gold Radiance Mask. So I see Sonia Dakar, she is an esthetician here in Los Angeles, and I see her for my facials, and she gave me this mask, and it has this kind of rose gold inside, and you really, really, really get like a radiant, smooth skin afterwards. And especially when I do this in the evening, I really see a difference in the next morning, that I really glow. And also in here, the same ingredient which is in Easy, it has jojoba oil in here, which makes the skin smooth and which doesn't dry it out. So this has been an incredible face mask for me. So if you have a dry skin, I would highly, highly recommend it. Then for sunscreens, I think after using a good oil or moisturizer, I think sunscreen is super, super essential in everyone's skincare routine. I have often shared my favorite, the Elta MD and the super good. And I'm normally not a huge fan of like tinted sunscreens and stuff, because I always feel it looks very fake or the color is completely off. I do use this one, which is the CODS Healthier Sunscreen Face Moisture Lightly Tinted SPF 35. And it's quite an interesting one. The first time when you use it, I will show you guys. It has zinc in there too, which you need when you're looking for a sunscreen. So it is really an interesting texture, because it almost feels like a silicone. So when I spread it out, as you can see, it blends in super smooth, and it almost feels like, the first time I put it on my face, I was like, this is weird. So I really like this as like an everyday, or when I don't want to wear any makeup and you do want to have like a little bit of tinted moisturizer. Yeah, this one is really, really great. And I don't say this very often about any sunscreens. I've been stick to the Elta MD and to that super good one forever, but this is the only tinted moisturizer I also like. This is another project from Sonia Dakar as well, and it is the Blemish Buster. tinted spot treatment. So many of you guys ask what I do whenever I have pimples or breakouts. I also have pimples and breakouts because I am human. I covered one up here. When you put this on your pimple, it just basically dry. I don't know what this is, what the ingredients are in here, but it completely dries out your pimple. Sonia de Carme, all herself, is also clean beauty, very important. And the next day when I wake up, whenever I have some big volcano up coming up, this is my best way to go, and it really helps take everything out. Then I wanted to share a couple of my favorite makeup items. Recently, I've been wearing actually lip liner more often. I was never really into it, but I think this was because I could never really find like the right colors. I switched between these three, and they're kind of the same looking, but they're slightly different, and it just really depends on the day which one I grab. I have these. This is my really like to go. I've been using this forever. This is the Lip Cheat from Charlotte Tilbury. She also has a Pillow Talk, which I really, really love. Then I have this Laura Mercier, and this is the one I'm actually wearing right now. So it's almost the same as my lip color, but it just gives it this little extra, can you say, volume for your lips? I don't know. And then I also have this MAC one. It's almost the same, and this is the color Dervish. I always like on other people kind of a new color, but whenever I put the new color on, I feel my face and the lips just blend in with each other, and it just doesn't look good. So let me show you guys quickly what I did for my lip today and what I've been doing lately. So I've been using the Laura Mercier hazelnut one, and I just draw a little over, and I normally do the outside. I tap a little bit. Then this is the Tarte Colada, so I put this in the middle. It's kind of like a matte lipstick, but it does feel creamy on the lips, which I really, really like. And then I often put some Dr. Barbara Sturm, some lip balm on here to give it some shine. Lately, I've just been putting on some like concealer, eyebrows, mascara, and then I do the lips because I always feel that just like finish immediately the look. And for the basic, for the base, a foundation and a brand I've been using, which I really, really love, is Ilia. They're also like a clean beauty brand with really nice ingredients in their products. They also make a lot of shades, which is really, really nice because for every shade or skin tone, they would have something if you have really dark skin or very, very light. That is really, really nice. It comes like this, so I often just add it like that on my hand, and then I just add a little sponge or brush and I apply my foundation. I do have to say, sometimes when I travel though, this can make quite a little bit of a mess. So if you're traveling a lot, I'm not sure if this would be a good idea, but the product itself to have at home is really, really, really good. Then for mascara, this you can literally get at any CVS. I've been using this for years. I really like this Maybelline one, Colossal. So this is the little brush. As you can see, there's not that much mascara on it, so that makes your eyelashes not very clumpy, but it does give this like very voluminous look. I wanted to share a couple of my new favorite hair products. So I have very dry ends. I have been putting too much heat on it, I guess. And also I wash my hair way too often. I wash it almost every day and I should not. But when I work out, I always want to have fresh hair. I don't know if anyone else struggles with this. And obviously with the dry weather where we're at now, my hair is just very, very dry. So what I put in the ends right now is the Gisu hair oil. And Gisu is obviously from my fellow Dutchie, Negin. And the active ingredient in here is like the honey. She has the bees in Holland. And it has this beautiful, like, beautiful oil. What I really love about this oil is that it doesn't make your hair super, super oily. It just gives it a nice shine. Because I've tried many face oils and even the trick with coconut oil, but with my fragile hair, it just becomes an oil mess. Actually, the easiest has exactly the same thing. Even though it is an oil, it doesn't feel oily at the skin at all. If you apply it, it mainly absorbs. So that's why a lot of guys, or even Max and Jason, use it too. And if you have like leftover Ise oil, you can put it on your eyebrows, you can put it in your hair, on your cuticles. Multifunctional. But often after I style my hair, I give it like a little blowout this morning. I try to do it every evening. You can even put it on damp hair when you come out of the shower. A shampoo I've been using a lot is this Functional Beauty. As you can see, they're almost done. It's been growing a lot. I remember in my earlier videos, my hair was like this short. So quarantine has been helping, maybe because I'm obviously not working as much, so the constant heat of blow dryers and irons and brushes every day just really cause damage to your hair. So my hair really had time to recover. So the shampoo I've been using is this Function Beauty one, and this is actually a personalized one. It has my name on it, I guess. You go online and they do like a whole test, and based on that they make the right shampoo for you. So I wanted to have like voluminous shine and also very strength. I hope you guys enjoy watching this video, and I hope you guys enjoy watching my new favorite beauty items. If you have any products you are obsessed with, or if you have any questions for me or any questions about Ise, then let me know in the comments down below. I will try to answer all of them. We're almost at 1,000,000. Oh my god, thank you guys. Never have done this without you, all of you guys, especially for the people who've been there from the beginning. Thank you so much for all your support as well. So don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys very soon. Bye bye.